In 2021, you can either walk into a supermarket in Mumbai or order from an app and find food from all across the world, irrespective of the season. The 19th century brought in a wave of industrialization that allowed us to transport and store food grains for a longer amount of time further from their origin in cities like Mumbai. This allowed for a large influx of workers, partly because of the increase in availability of food. In today's time, these luxuries like the means of production, processing, packaging, retailing, transportation of food result in high amount of carbon emissions, greenhouse effect, and other factors which degrade the environment. After speaking to local vendors in Warsaw, Thane, and Sakinaka, while also studying larger supermarkets, let's take a look at what we found. Traces of rice have been found from as far back as 7000 BC in the Indo-Gangetic Plain. Different varieties are also imported from Italy, Japan, etc. Hybrid strains introduced during the Green Revolution have greater yields, making it India's most produced crop, but also require excess fertilizers and pesticides which harm the topsoil. Corn was domesticated in North America 10,000 years ago, and capsicum has been found in the region as early as 5200 BCE. Both were brought to India by traders. The local markets get all varieties of capsicum from Nashik and Palghar, and the red and yellow bell peppers come from Bangalore. The crop is vulnerable to pests and plant diseases that affect its quality. To protect it, designed chemical fertilizers are used, which can be toxic for the consumption and harmful for the environment. In today's time, corn reaches the local markets from Nashik, Rajasthan, etc. Corn production requires a lot of water and chemical fertilizers, which can result in high percentage of nitrogen pollution in water bodies nearby. It is the third largest crop grown in India. Because of the agricultural practices, there is an increase in productivity, but that can induce sterility and can affect its nutrients. Apples in local markets come from the northernmost states of India. The number of Indian apples in the market saw a decline last year, especially due to lower temperatures than usual during the flowering season and the lack of labor due to the COVID-19 pandemic during the harvest season. This led to increase in imports from Iran, the United States, etc. in the markets. Grape cultivation originated in Armenia back in 6500 BC, from where it spread eastward to Iran and Afghanistan. Large-scale cultivation in India was started in 1300 AD by the invaders from these regions. Most grapes in Mumbai are from Nashik, with some red grapes largely imported from California. High temperatures can reduce the acidity of the grapes and can cause loss in color intensity. Fishes in Mumbai are mostly caught fresh from the sea. The livelihood of fishermen has been impacted by the pandemic, resulting in higher priced fishes. Salmon and tuna have seen a decline in markets as they are found in the deeper parts of the sea. So, the boats go out for shorter trips due to the rise in petrol prices. Many chemicals like formaldehyde, mercury, and pesticides that pollute the sea have been found in such fishes, which makes eating fish a big worry. Basa is a native catfish from Thailand. There are several Basa farms now in India. Basa has a tendency to absorb nutrients from contaminated waters, letting toxins inside its body. Evidence of cattle domestication in the Indus Valley dates back 10,000 years ago, with the Indian subspecies of cattle being bred from wild mammal called aurochs. Sarda Farms supplies organic bottled milk to most of Mumbai and gets its milk from Nashik. However, local dairies get milk from tabelas in places like Vasai and Aray, which the dairies sell and deliver to people's home in the neighborhood on the basis of loose packets. Major brands like Amul also buy milk directly from the farmers, package it in Tetra Paks or sealed plastic bags and send it across the country. Bottled milk uses glass bottles that can be reused by washing them. The plastic used for packets is recycled to make irrigation pipes, plastic sheets, etc. Tetra Paks are 100% recyclable and made up of 70 to 90% paperboard, but cannot be recycled like normal paper because it has aluminium foil liner and polythene cap with the carton, which makes the effort to recycle rarely profitable. One average Tetra Pak holds 1 liter of milk, which may seem like a better option than 2 bags of milk or 2 bottles. But even a single Tetra Pak uses much more material and is less recyclable, and thus Tetra Paks are more harmful to the environment. To import and transport food items, the transport facility required uses fuel, which causes pollution due to its carbon emissions. For example, for every 100 km traveled by plane, 15.4 kg of carbon dioxide is released. Buying vegetable from local vendors reduces the use of plastic and transportation packaging. Therefore, it is better to buy locally produced food, which may or may not be seasonal, but would always be fresher option. Adopting greener ways would reduce climate change, which can directly affect the productivity and quality of the food items we consume.